Imagine future. The future is for me a life without cancer in a healthy body. I'm going to talk about the tumor microenvironment. And to tell you what a microenvironment is, I'm going to explain that for a long time, cancer research has been focusing mostly on the cancer cell. So it is a cell that is mutated in the organism and it starts proliferating. And this cell has some genetic mutation and has been studied as a single entity. But this cell is not alone, it's in our body, which is mostly healthy, and it lives in an environment. So I'll make you think about environment. There are different environments, and our feelings in different environments change. This is, for instance, the sea. Then here you can see a more dramatic environment, mountains. And here is the countryside, more peaceful. And the cancer cell somehow is surrounded by an environment, and it is different. It changes according how the environment changes. So this is the story of a little cancer cell that starts in a healthy epithelium, and it gets mutated. And the mutated cell starts growing, and it stays very small, and eventually dies as a little tumor if there is no interaction with the environment. And the tumor environment, since it is small around the tumor, is called microenvironment, and it is made by the healthy cells of our body. For instance, inflammatory cells, immune cells, endothelial cells that make blood vessels, fibroblasts, and the idea that to interact the organism is that our body is corrupted by the cancer and starts helping cancer growth. And the idea of the future is to help to shape the body to fight the cancer from inside. So the first thing that has been studied in the microenvironment is the ability of a tumor cell to stimulate vessels, our transport of blood, to bring nutrition to this initial transformed group of cells. This is called angiogenesis, and basically what you see, it's a small tumor is able to recruit capillaries from existing blood vessels. And through pyrolysis of capillaries starts to get nutrition and also the capability to go around the body and metastasize. So therapies have been developed from initial studies of, for instance, Judah Folkman or Gulino to fight angiogenesis, and many drugs have been developed that are used now, actually, for cancer, for instance, colorectal cancer, to fight the angiogenesis. And so what happens is that we can suffocate the tumor, we can avoid that the tumor gets food, and so this is basically starving it. And this is the first action against the microenvironment. We can also address this in prevention. This is what the research of myself and the group has done, trying to prevent this early, so to avoid that the tumor can make those blood vessels. But the microenvironment, as you see, for instance, in the mountains or in the woods, is not only one cell, it's not only endothelial cells, but it's many, many inhabitants. And you can see, for instance, in this cartoon, that there are many inflammatory cells, macrophages, neutrophils, mast cells, there are fibroblasts, there are normal non-transformed epithelial cells. This is from a review article. And all of those somehow are in the tumor and they can cooperate with the tumor. So these are eventually all target cells. So to imagine again the environment of the tumor, this is the tumor cell, and those are lymphocytes that should kill it, but they don't, when the tumor is able to talk them to be ally instead of enemies. Why this happens? Because our good cells are somehow induced by the tumor cells to become bad cells and help the tumor. And this is called, with the immune cells, polarization. So we have macrophages 1, which are good, anti-angiogenic, anti-cancer, and there's macrophages M2 that somehow are able to help the tumor grow. This happens because the tumors don't invent anything. They use what is in our somehow history, genetic history. And this is the principle of the wound healing. When there is a damage, when our body is hurt, the lymphocytes run to help, to fight the enemies, to fight the wound, the damage. And then they recruit other immune cells, so neutrophils, macrophages, effector immune cells. And then when they fought the enemies, they have to build new tissue to make the scar. And so there is this phenomenon that makes the cells grow. And the tumor cell has a similar mechanism. So there is a wound, basically, that does not heal. So we came to the idea with Michael Sporn, which is one American investigator very known for inventing prevention, to use the microenvironment of the tumor as a target to help our body to fight the tumors from inside. We also discovered with our team, in particular with the young investigator, Antonino Bruno, because Imagine the Future is also the young scientist, and with my husband, Douglas Noonan, who is professor at Insubria, University of Varese, that there are certain cells are called natural killer. So a killer natural that should attack the tumor cells. But we discovered that in tumors, some of those cells are polarized, so they become helping the tumor growth. They don't kill the tumor cells. They're not able to do it anymore, but they feed them. They make them grow faster. And so those cells, we can try to re-educate to be good guys and help fighting the tumor. How we can do this? These are inflammatory cells. So the epidemiology has shown that using anti-inflammatory drugs can somehow fight the inflammation, also prevent the tumors. A very simple, very cheap drug that has been able to do this is aspirin. There are a lot of reports that show that people taking aspirin every day have less cancer. And so also, the interesting thing that aspirin derives from a molecule from the nature, from plants. This is a salicylic acid from the willow tree. And there are many plant phytochemical derivatives that are able somehow to prevent tumor. What is prevention? What is chemo prevention? This has been defined by Michael Sporn, that I mentioned before, a mentor, a collaborator. They use specific agents to reverse, suppress, or prevent the carcinogenic process to invasive cancer. Now we can make many aspirins from plants, and particularly from the diet, from food derivatives. This is very interesting because we know that our diet can help us stay in good health. So I'm a chemist originally, and in the plants we can find, for instance, genistein from soy, psilocybin, quercetin from apples, resveratrol from red wine, epigallocatechin gallate from green tea, and then, for instance, curcumin from spices, from curry. Also retinoids, for instance, lycopene from tomatoes, beta-carotene from apricots or carrots. These are all good molecules that can help our body stay healthy and avoid that our good cells become bad and help the tumor. This is a new field, it's been around for a few years, it's called nutraceutics. What is a nutraceutical? You can see here a pill with fruits and vegetables inside. It is a term derived from nutrition and pharmaceutical. This term is applied to products that are isolated from foodstuff, and besides being nutrition, obviously, they can be also of therapy. And there's another term, which is functional food, which is a food that besides being for life, for nutrition, is also good for medical purposes. We have done many investigations in the field. I have over 330 publications, and many are on this topic. And the recent study has been on beer hops. Why beer hops? Because you know that it helps transporting beer in a good state of health, adding the hops. The hops also gives the bitter flavor. It is very fashionable, but it's also something good to protect beer from going bad. And so, as for many other plants, we can isolate principles and use them. And we have studied one polyphenol, antioxidant, anti-inflammatory from beer, which is called xanthohumol. And as a chemist, in collaboration with other chemists at the University of Pisa, with Armando Rossello and team, we made modifications, like it has been done from salicylic acid from the willow tree, and made new xanthohumols that are more bioavailable that can become some sort of aspirin from beer. So this is something that we can use to make a drug, possibly low toxic, from nature. Also, another study that we do is, for instance, from a waste product. You know that olive oil is a product of Mediterranean diet, which is very good for our health, but polyphenols are mostly soluble, so when we make the oil, we throw away from with the water a lot of very good principles for our health. So in a collaboration with the factory in Tuscany, we have made extracts from the waste waters from olives. You know, when you make the oil, you throw away the water parts. And this is also a problem for nature because you have to discard them. We can filter, we can concentrate, and make some functional food from the olive waste. And this is very rich in polyphenols, and we're studying now. And both those discoveries have been patented, and they can become products for the future. Also, when we do prevent early, we can use low toxic compounds, so just, for instance, caloric restriction or dietary factors. This is a study that we published in Nature Reviews of Clinical Oncology with an American friend, William Lee, that we can use the dietary derivatives to prevent angiogenesis. And the earlier you start, the less toxic molecules you can use. When the tumor starts advancing, then you have to use a little more toxic drugs because you have a larger mass to fight. Now, so prevention has acquired a new concept, which is called interception. So the cancer, you can avoid to have it, but when it's already running, you can intercept, just block it there as it is. And many of the things that you can do just avoiding expensive drugs is to try not to get a cancer. And these are the things that one can do. Do not smoke, keep a weight in a healthy range, drink little alcohol, try to get nice food like fruits, vegetables, good drinks, fruit juices, spices, avoid infections, exercise. Sport is very important. You can prevent cancer just by doing long walks or cancer. And watch your environment and get regular evidence-based screening. And this is Prevention Interception, a publication with Andrea De Cenzi, Alberto Costa, and Franco Cavalli. So going to the end, basically cancer is a conspiracy of good guys turned bad. The microenvironment can be chemo-prevented from helping the tumor to grow and progress. So we can keep our microenvironment healthy by doing exercise, getting low-toxic drugs, anti-inflammatory, or eating a very good Mediterranean diet, for instance. And so this is my vision for the future, a nice environment. You can be here and dream of a happy and healthy life. And also, you can help these immune cells. And there are a lot of recent therapies in immunology to re-evaluate the potential of immune cells. And these cells in the environment can fight the tumor and avoid this growth. So the future for me is having a healthy body, fighting a cancer, or actually preventing that the cancer ever starts. Thank you.